if there are proud recipients of ayuda that actually help them and change their lives because of the ayuda that they receive, please, I beg you to make a content how the ayuda changed your life. Okay? You know, nobody is proud to say na naka-receive sila ng ayuda. Bakit? Either yung ayudang na-receive nila ay, kunwari sinabi 10,000. Ang na-receive lang ng mga yan, hindi naman talaga 10,000 eh.
Kaltas yan eh, may kaltas.
May kaltas yan. So, you know, ayun ang hinahanap ko. Lahat yung naka-receive ng 10,000 ayuda, please, di ba? Say I, di ba? Ngayon, walang nagmo-move forward kasi nga, yung mga naka-receive ng ayuda ng supposedly 10,000, hindi naman talaga nila nakuha yung 10,000. Okay? Pagkatapos, yung mga nakakuha ng 10,000, hindi naman sila dapat nakakuha ng
10,000. Yun!
Yun! Diba? So hindi that is qualified. Why, yes. So that is why they claim na napakaraming taong nagbenepisyo dito sa ayudahan na to, walang proud na nakareceive. Bakit? Wala. Kasi yung kumubra ng 10,000, either kumubra na lang, kasi eh, syempre, mabuti na yung measure ako kaysa naman mapunta sa kanila lahat, ganyan. Yes. Ganun yung isip nila. Or, yung nakakuha ng 10,000, they are not qualified, so they cannot be seen in public. Na nakakuha sila ng 10K, di ba?
Or halos lahat mga kapamilya ng kung sino yes. nakaupo dyan.
Mapapahin daw, nakamag-anak ni barangay captain yan, kamag-anak ni mayor yan, di ba? So nobody's really proud, di ba?
Sa ilang bilyong ayuda ng pinamimigay ni Martin Romualdez, hanggang ngayon, 35% pa rin yung trust rating.
So kaya nga parang sa akin, ano eh, ayoko rin i-undermine yung paayuda-ayuda niya dahil mukhang ano eh, mukhang ginagapang talaga eh.
Gapangan talaga, gapangan talaga, gapangan talaga.
Ginagapang talaga kasi hodang ano eh.
Tapos ngayon ha, tapos ang budget for 2025, it's 500 million more ha, than the previous year's budget. From 4.7 trillion to about 5.2 million, billion ngayon. Tapos they will approve daw in record time. Eh. Sa kanila naman lahat ng Kongreso, lahat ng representante.
Wala namang away dyan.
Wala nang away, di ba? Wala nang debate. You pointed it out a lot of times already, Joey, na wala nang fiscalizing doon sa house.
It's a dead house.
They are all in Martin's pocket. Yeah, it's a dead house. It's a dead house.
Oh, ayan, namakit si Carlos. Oh, Carlos.
Oh, hi, Carlos. Okay, go. Nakamute ka, Carlos.
Nakamute ka, Carlos. Hello, Carlos. Carlos, hindi mo ako madidiba kung hindi ka magsasalita.
Come on.
Oh. Grabe. Ikaw po yung fake news niya eh.
Hindi na ako makatulong dito, Joey. Pinabasa mo yung comment niya. tapos nag-post pa si ano si Prof Carlos no na bakit daw hindi ibalik under the AFP yung PCG. Tangina naman Prof Carlos. Gusto na talagang i-militarize yung pinagagawa diyan. Papa-under na daw sa PCG kasi nga daw yung CCG under ng PLA People's Liberation Army. Under nga sila sa PLA pero in a civilian authority. Ina-touch lang sila doon. Kasi nga ano, and then tayo kaya tinanggal natin 'yan sa AFP kasi parang if I remember right, parang meron tayo arrangement with Japan na parang magpo-provide sila ng aid sa ating Coast Guard. Pero the yung Japanese constitution ata or some other law
do not it prohibits them to
provide aid sa mga military na undertaking. Kaya ginawa ng Pilipinas ginawang civilian under the DOTR, no? Department of Transportation, DOT siya noon, no? Ngayon DOTR, yung PCG para ma-facilitate nga yung tulong ng Japanese Coast Guard noon, no? Tapos ngayon gusto niya ibalik sa AFP. Ano bang layunin mo, Prof Carlos? Gusto mong ibalik sa AFP?
What's the rationale of Prof?
What's the rationale? Well, exactly.
That's the question.
The only answer I can provide is that to militarize talaga the operations diyan. 'Di ba?
And it becomes more vulnerable to ano, diba,
to
mistakes and to false flag and everything.
Tapos kanina, 'di ba? Nabasa mo ba, Joey? Yung resulta ng bilateral ano, consultation mechanism na pag-usapan nila doon na China and the Philippines will re-establish their direct military communication. 'Di ba ayaw ni Gibo noon sa hearing ni Prime Minister ayaw niya? Ngayon, in-establish na nga, nag-usap yung DFA, di ba? In-establish kanina, binalita kanina. Na
may that is why the walkout is really getting ano eh.
Yes, so
really
anong nangyari, Joey? Anong nangyari? Immediately after, itong si Carpio at si Tariela, nag-press release. Ang sabi ni Justice Carpio, huwag kang maniwala dyan, hindi epektibo yan. Kasi yung China, hindi pinapansin yung tawag natin. Eh yung China naman, I think that was about a year ago or 2 years ago, has been saying na...
Hindi nang gusto nila.
Nang gusto nila and they are trying
in fact. That was one of the output na pinagmamalaki actually kuyang ni BBM nung nag-visit siya sa China.
Yes.
They open yung direct line between the people who handles the South China Sea affairs at saka yung mga tao nila doon na nag-handle ng South China Sea affairs na direct yung communication.
Direct communication. So, yan naman ang ginawa ni Admiral Carlos noon, Joey.
Oo. In which si Admiral Carlos pala yung...
Very successful siya. For 2 years, 20 resupply missions without any incident. Kasi yun nga, yun lang ang new model agreement na may transcript na rin na ba? Kasi, di ba, challenge nila yung Chinese embassy na fake news daw, na may arrangement. Tapos pinalabas yung transcript tsaka yung voice recording sa conversation. O anong nangyari? Di ba? So, if you look at the history, ay yung talaga namang, the one who's lying actually is the Philippine side. It's not the Chinese side.
It's very obvious. It's too obvious. And then the retaliation of Gibo dyan is so lame. Saying na, wiretapping ito, na ano ito. Yes. Parang, sir, kapag ka po may meeting na ganitong level, talaga pong tinatranscribe po yun. Anong problema ninyo?
Pero Joey, bakit ayaw nila na yung direct communication? And the only reason is hindi daw pinapansin ng China. Assuming lang na hindi pinapansin yung ng China yung mga tawag natin previously. Why couldn't you try it now? And see kung talagang hindi ba talaga papansinin ng China. And then document that na meron kang proof na tinawagan nga, nakipag-usap nga or attempted to communicate with China and then the Chinese are not responding. Saka mo lang masasabi, Justice Carpio, na it's not working. At meron pa isang kalasal na American accent na Pilipino na amboy talaga. Ganon din yung ano niya doon sa ABS-CBN nga na huwag niyo i-interview niyan kasi hindi pinapansin ng China ang tawag natin. Give us proof na tumawag ang Philippines ay hindi pinansin ng China. Then we will believe.
The narrative that they are pushing kasi kuyang ano, the narrative that they are pushing is we did all the diplomatic ways in order to settle issues with China. Yun yung gusto nilang palabasin eh. Yo. Na as if nauubos yung diplomatic ways.
Right.
Hindi po nauubos ang diplomasya, unli po yan.
Unli yan,
hindi nauubos ang diplomasya. Ngayon, binobobo tayo ni Gibo at saka nito ni Justice Carpio na it's not working. So are you saying that what's happening now, that this
strategy
is working? Na hindi nakakapangisda yung mga manging isda natin.
May naputol na daliri.
Nag-e-escalate yung issue dyan. So, you call this working?
Right.
Diba? Ngayon, yung notion kasi na we tried all the diplomatic ways, okay? Is a lie. Okay? It is a lie.
It is.
The diplomatic ways is not, is inexhaustible. Okay? Hindi po yan na-exhaust. Hindi po yan na-exhaust. Diba? You just have to try and try again. Ngayon, kung kunwari, tumatawag ka, hindi ka pinapansin. Bakit? Baka ayaw ka usap yung tumatawag. Sino tumatawag? Yun. Si Gibo. Baka ayaw ka usap ng China si Gibo.
Yun.
Then you find another person who will, ano, no? Ganun lang yan. Kasimple.
Yan ang diplomacy. Tapos, Joey, pagka meron talaga silang proof at evidence, talagang they've exhausted na all diplomatic efforts, ilabas niya na yung transcript.
Mm-mm.
Kasi yung mga formal negotiations,
transcript on the Filipino side.
On the Filipino side. Tingnan natin.
But they don't want it released, so that's why they ask Carlos.
Exactly. Exactly. Diba? So, this government talaga is really peddling lies to everyone, no? May nag-comment nga, Joey, no, doon sa first episode ng live namin ni June, na hanggang president, from the president daw hanggang barangay captain, grabe na doon yung kurakot.
Totoo yan. And that was made possible by the ayuda
policy,
no?
Yun, tama.
It was made possible by the ayudahan.
Ayudahan, yes.
Ayan. Totoo yan. I mean, kaya ito yung sinasabi ko, napakasimple lang nung call ko eh. Okay? Napakasimple lang nung call ko dyan sa ayuda na yan. If there are proud recipients of ayuda that actually help them and change their lives because of the ayuda that they receive, Please, I beg you to make a content how the ayuda changed your life. Okay? You know, nobody is proud to say na naka-receive sila ng ayuda. Bakit? Either, yung ayudang na-receive nila ay, kunwari, sinabi 10,000. Ang na-receive lang ng mga yan, hindi naman talaga 10,000 eh.
Kaltas yan eh, may kaltas.
May kaltas yan. So, you know, ayun ang hinahanap ko. Lahat yung naka-receive ng 10,000 ayuda, please, di ba? Say I, di ba? Ngayon, walang nagmo-move forward kasi nga, yung mga naka-receive ng ayuda ng supposedly 10,000, hindi naman talaga nila nakuha yung 10,000.
Mm.
Okay? Pagkatapos, yung mga nakakuha ng 10,000, hindi naman sila dapat nakakuha ng
10,000. Yun!
Yun! Diba? So that is why, so that is why they claim na napakaraming taong nagbenepisyo dito sa ayudahan na to, walang proud na nakareceive. Bakit? Wala. Kasi yung kumubra ng 10,000, either kumubra na lang, kasi eh, syempre, mabuti na yung measure ako kaysa naman mapunta sa kanila lahat, ganyan. Yes. Ganun yung isip nila. Or, yung nakakuha ng 10,000, they are not qualified, so they cannot be seen in public. Na nakakuha sila ng 10K, di ba?
Or halos lahat mga kapamilya ng kung sino nakaupo dyan.
Mapapain out, nakamag-anak ni Barangay Captain yan, kamag-anak ni Mayor yan, di ba? So nobody's really proud, di ba? Ayun.
So yun.
Ganon. Ayun.
Kaya hanggang ngayon, 35 pa rin yung ano, trust rating ni... sa ilang bilyong ayuda ng pinamimigay ni Martin Romualdez, hanggang ngayon 35% pa rin yung trust rating.
True, Diyos me. Parang tumataas yung rating niya eh, no? Mababa, tumataas.
I think 29 ata yun, tapos nag-35 ngayon.
39 before, tapos 35 na ngayon.
29 ata, tapos naging 35.
Parang
medyo tumaas nga eh.
Tumataas. Ayun. So kaya nga parang sa akin ano eh, ayoko rin i-undermine yung paayuda-ayuda niya dahil mukhang ano eh, mukhang ginagapang talaga eh.
Gapangan talaga.
Ginagapang talaga kasi hodang ano eh.
Tapos ngayon ha. Tapos ang budget for 2025, it's 500 million more ha than the previous year's budget, from 4.7 trillion to about 5.2 billion ngayon. Tapos they will approve daw in record time. Sa kanila naman lahat ng Kongreso, lahat ng representante. Wala nang away, di ba? Wala nang debate. Mm-hmm. You pointed it out a lot of times already, Joey, na wala nang fiscalizing doon sa House.
It's a dead house.
They are all in Martin's pocket. Yeah, it's a dead house. It's a dead house.
Totoo, ayun. Hi, Tita Itz!
Yep.
Hello, hello, both of you. Ay, nako, good afternoon na dito.
Ayan. Kumusta?
Ito, excited kami kasi may maisog na dito sa Canada. So, we have two.
Right. Vancouver, no? Yes,
and there's one also that's going to happen in Toronto sa August. Wala pang venue. So, mas malapit ako doon. So, excited kaming lahat from here in Canada. Kasi feeling namin laylayo. No? Sa libro na lang ni Attorney Vic, para siyang ano, ginto na inaabang-abang namin. In fact, may nag-message na about, may nag-post na about the information on how to buy it. Pero kasi yung payment kinemis, kailangan pa nilang ayusin. So, we're just waiting for that exciting. Anyway, so ano ba? We're patiently waiting for what's gonna happen over the weekend, no? Sa July 20, and then of course the SONA. I was preparing something. Matagal na din ako hindi nagva-vlog, Joey, kasi ano, ang tagal mag-edit. So, kaya pala kayo live na lang, no? But I don't have that benefit kasi ito.
Kaya nga eh, mas maganda yung live eh. Wala nang edit. Oo,
correct.
Sige, pagkatapos, okay na.
Okay na.
Konting diet pa para meron man ano, face value. Gaya nito si gandang Joey. Ay, naku.
Grabe si Tita.
Diba? Kasi may ano din eh. We were talking about kanina na isingit ko lang, segue natin, Sir E. Kanina sabi niyo bakit parang hindi nakikinig ang China yan lagi ko nakakalimutan yung pangalan nito kasi hindi siya mabalor sa akin, si Sec Gibo, no? Bakit hindi nakikinig? Hindi tama kayo na diplomacy kasi is unlimited yan. We will always find a course to find the diplomatic channel that we can. Ang problema kasi China also knows the caliber of the people we are sending. Siyempre bago yan ano.
Na ano na nila yan, background check na nila
yan. Ibibet nila yan eh.
Correct. and if there's no benefit at all to speak with this person, yes, parang walang influence yung taong yan. And they, we really have to find that perfect chan, person, a person na ideal na magkaroon kahit konting impluensya sa course ng diplomatic communication nila. And then it's really ridiculous to say that there are no transcripts. Imposible yan. Ano yan? Ang pag-uusap nila, isa sa ulo lang, may memoryahin nila. Impossible. That is so ridiculous to even.
And that's against ano, no? In-explain yan ni Isas eh, na it's part of protocol. Na
yeah, it's protocol talaga.
Na you are representing your country, so whatever it is that you're going to talk about, it should be something that it should be encapsulated by ano no, by
it should
by,
be recorded
oh by
kasi you have to you there will come a time that you have to go back to all those transcripts.
Anong and yes, check yung, the ano, check the context on how the context words were said, ganyan. And because, it's very, very important, ha?
Because you're speaking for the entire country, ha?
In matters of conflict, you have to have documentation to prove what you are trying.
Naka-transcript nga yung ordinaryong ano eh, oral defamation case dito, naka-transcript na sa korte, eh, yan pa.
Yan pa. True.
The only problem kasi, this is not transparent. It's between the top the people who are yes, and they can pretty much twist the story without having to show any documentation. Right. Doon tayo kasi ang guys niyan is national security, right? They will not present it in the general public because they will say there are some sensitive matters there that that cannot be divulged for reasons of national security.
Yeah. It's I agree, no? Pero they've tested the resolve of China nung tinawag nilang fake news yung assertion ng China na merong new model agreement.
Yeah.
China released part of the transcript of that conversation. Oh. So talagang
it doesn't do any favor doon sa ating right, souring relationship with them. Right. Kasi parang medyo nagkakainitan na nga tayo, tapos sasabihin mo pa na sinungaling yung isa.
Sinungaling sila? Hindi.
That is very true. That is true. Kaya lang, as long as the government will stay on their position na China is hiding something or China is lying, then patuloy lang naman yun na paulit-ulit nila yun ang gagamitin nila. Whatever China is going to say is not the truth. Ito yung problema, no? Meron tayong troll or some other people na entity watching right now. When we are talking about these things, we are not saying we are pro-China, ha? Kasi dito, lagi yan ganun eh.
Ganun naman talaga eh. If you are against them, you are pro-China.
And we do not benefit from talking the truth and bringing out in the open.
Inaanak ba yung tawag dyan pag ninong ka sa kasal? Anong tawag dyan, Joey, sa Tagalog? Halimbawa, ninong ako sa isang couple, ha? Anong tawag ng tawag dyan? Inaanak sa kasal, ano?
Oh, ninong ka.
Ninong ako. Ay, yung inaanak sa kasal ko nga. Eh, tinawag akong pro-China ka talaga.
Talaga?
Ako din.
Grabe, you know. Talagang kulang talaga ang critical thinking talaga sa mga ano.
I really decided to do the live in Bisaya. Kasi nga, I have a lot of Bisaya na talagang cannot accept our arguments. No matter how, no matter how scholarly or academic you do it, talagang
they won't.
Sarado talaga. Yeah.
Uh-oh. And nga pala no, I would like to express my gratitude to Prof June Abines for vlogging. Invite ka rin si Prof June dito sa live. Nagsabi na ako kay Prof Anne so one of these days invite.
One of these days. Kaya nga, Joey and pasok ko na lang din. We've discussing ni June kanina no na we will do a Taglish version of our podcast. We will invite no other bloggers no and other resource persons like you. Sas, si Mami Pebbles okay na siya, ikaw okay na rin. I don't know about Sas. Tio Moreno will definitely be one of our guests next week maybe, and then hopefully Prof Anna and all the others no na are like-minded individuals no. So
just tell us when.
Yes. We're ironing out our schedules with June. So hopefully by next week we can draft a month long schedule. The guest post na send the invitations na. Char.
Okay, kuya.
Feeling sikat ah.
You're gaining ano, you're gaining prominence. Ayan.
Kukunti kasi yung Bisaya, my husband is Bisaya and I, you know, I listen to it. Medyo naiintindihan naman. Naisip ko tuloy bakit walang Kapampangan version. So, sana meron din eh, no. Pero anyway, mas ano kami sa Tagalog. So I think we're gonna be using Tagalog more. Uh-huh. And ano lang for the 20th and the 22nd. Okay. So ito na naman tayo, no. Exciting. Parang hindi we are anticipating. Ano ba? Positively wanting for something to happen, Joey, on the 20th. Okay, so here's the thing. No? Doon tayo sa babalik. So, EB, you were here during the discussion na sinabi natin na we have to patiently wait. Ah? Joey, talagang tayong dalawa dyan eh.
Right.
So, patient at saka si kilos na. Okay, so here's the thing. Well, I was trying to go backtrack what happened noong unang Marcos. It's very important to know that we are not dealing with two different governments here. We are dealing with a continuity, a sequel of the first Marcos. Tingnan niyo po ito from my point of view lang. No? Ito'y opinion lamang. No? Pero syempre, it's backed by research. In 1986, when they were ousted, both Bongbong and Aimee were already in politics. Okay. So they were already in politics and it was abruptly cut when they were all exiled in Hawaii. So the United States sila ang tumulong to para ma-avoid ang civil war dyan sa Philippines and death of many Filipinos by having Marcos remain during that a fateful day. So lumipad sila sa Hawaii and stayed there for a while. Remember that during that time Cory Aquino came back and was forced into a snap election. Challenge siya ni Marcos. And through the votes, she won. But Marcos contested it repeatedly. And the revolution broke up. Yan yung kwento niyan. Huh? So pinatapon, America said we should get them out of the Philippines so that nobody gets hurt. So yun yung naging papel na. They went to America and stayed there until 1992. The Marcos Sr. died already there. Cory Aquino gave way for the Marcoses, the remaining Marcoses, to go back to the Philippines because she wanted them to face all the charges and also to retrieve yung perang and kayamanan na we still weren't able to obtain. So when this family left, it was recorded that they had minimum of 40 luggages containing jewelries and gold bars na unaccounted until now. So they were bringing that. This is not fake news. You can go back to all the records and go back to all American reports regarding their stay in Hawaii. While they were in Hawaii, they resisted moving to any other country because katrechoso ang Mrs. Marcos. She didn't want to be in any other country that she will not have the same affluent lifestyle. Merong isang country na pumayag and that is Panama. During that time, it was Noriega who was the president.
Right.
So, but the moment that they were ready to move there, because Noriega promised them a palatial house and also according to the accounts, yung bahay is nasa top ng hill and overlooking the dagat. So it's beautiful. Not just exactly what they wanted. But then, Cory Aquino made that call to Noriega and said, if you're going to give them this place, you are already telling us that we are not, we're not going to be diplomatic with each other anymore. Parang sinabi niya, it's a sign of resistance against us. So hindi sila pinayagan. So stuck sila. And then in Hawaii and stayed there for a while. In 1992, they came back. Immediately after Joey, Bongbong Marcos, and they already started running very quietly. And this was my point here. They slowly and quietly crept back into power.
Tama.
It was never cut. Okay? So slowly and quietly, they never made big mistakes. Hindi rin sila maingay, disimulado lang. Kasi mahirap eh. Ang mata ng mundo nasa kanila, hinahabol pa natin yung pera natin, kayamanan ng Pilipinas sa kanila. So their movements were calculated. Neither, kumbaga ang kaluskos, maingat na maingat sa kaluskos. And then, now 2024, they're back in power, Sir EB.
Right.
So to say that, that we should wait the same way that we waited for the first Marcos, for me, there's a little problem there.
Mm.
Kasi, sec, ano to eh, continuation to, it's a saga. Mm. So, nakikita na natin yung signs on the second year.
Mm.
Why are we giving him the benefit that we gave to the first Marcos? Because we were thinking, baka naman magbabago pa, you know?
Sorry, tapusin mo muna.
And the difference is this, mm-hmm. We never had a standard for a president before. Magbigay nga kayo ng matinong presidente until Duterte came. No one. We did not have any standard. No one to compare with. We now have that. So, makikita naman natin yung disparity. It's polar differences. And I'm not saying that we should get another Duterte on there. But we have a standard now. Diba? We have a standard. And I don't know how much more we can take and how much more damage this guy will create and how long we will repair for that damage. Meron pa ba tayong PC to repair that damage? Yun lang ang sinasabi ko na hopefully on the 20th to the 22nd, merong mangyayari. But it does not hurt anyone physical body in the Philippines. Pero ang hinahanap ko lang is, ang sinasabi ko lang is, we never learned from the first Marcos. We are still not able to put our foot down, even if it's already in our face. And that makes me very, very sad because we are allowing it. And therefore, we already told everybody, this is the government we deserve.
Mm-hmm. Actually, Tito Eats, I agree in yung most part na sinabi mo na we should really it should not be part of our tolerance to put our foot down pagdating dun sa mga bagay na sobrang unacceptable. If it's gonna happen this weekend, I am not to stop it or to poop on it or whatnot, ganyan. Of course, I want that. I think ako ng konti doon sa it is a continuous, ganyan-ganyan na parang continuous na kwento na dapat natuto na tayo. I think yun yung problem eh. Meron talagang problem doon sa learning curve natin. Why? Because previously, we weren't really able to hold them accountable to what they did.
Tama.
That's the problem. That's why we cannot learn. That's why we cannot learn. So that is why ako no personally, kaya nga ako sabi ang lagi kong ang pinaka ayaw kong mangyari is we take the same route doon sa 1986 and be trapped with the same cycle all over again. Kasi noong 1986 nagpatalsik ka, wala namang na-revolutionize. Why? Because we weren't able to put the people accountable to justice. Diba?
They're back in power, in fact.
They are back in power. So, if we're going to do this again, ito lang yung aking parang medyo different doon sa sinabi mo. Ang sa akin, if we're going to do this again, this has to be done more intelligently than how it is done in 1986. Because 1986 did not bring us anything. It didn't change anything. Now, if we're not going to, if we're not going to unify our call, if we're not going to know what we really want, kung merong mangyayari this weekend or none, it's not going to bring a lasting change. We are up to another 1986, smoke na, isasatisfy lang yan yung mga egos natin ngayon na parang, something was changed, but we never really dealt with the real problem. Like, for example, after this ba, are we going to purge all the corrupt and ibibitin na ba natin sila pati warik isa-isa? There has to be for me, in order for the change to be truly, truly meaningful, the call should be consolidated. Whatever it is that we want to do should go towards more than taking over or change in power. Kasi yun lang yung call noong 1986, change in power eh. But they do not really know what they want.
Mm.
Diba? Ano ba talaga? Mag-industrialize? Ano bang gagawin? Ano ba ifo-focus? Ganyan-ganyan? Ano ba yung mga papalitan? Ano yung mga ganun-ganun? So ako, yun yung major concern ko. Yun yung major concern. Of course, I want change. And if BBM is going to be removed in power, that's one less problem. Mm. But at the same time, my long-term goal is not founded on the fact that there is a change in power. Kasi kung mag-change lang rin yan, pagkatapos wala naman tayong, di ba hindi naman unified yung call natin, tolerant pa rin tayo sa corruption, wala pa rin tayong mapapakulong, wala pa rin, you know, eh talaga siguro nga, Tita Itz, deserve natin itong ganitong klaseng government.
As I've said, no?
Tita Itz, siguro talaga deserve natin itong government na to. But you know, I am one with you in, ano, no? I am one with you in arousing the public that we should not accept this. We should not accept this. Diba? If you can go out and if you can, ano, show your disgust. And then, but when you do so, ito lang yung paalala ko, ha. And when you do so, do not forget to also think about what we really want. Diba? Huwag natin kalimutan yung part na yon. Aside dun sa kung kunwari, magkakaroon ng change in power, ganyan-ganyan. Then after that, what do we really want? Dapat, malinyahan ang mga oligarchs. Diba? Dapat mapamisahan ang lahat ng corrupt. Diba? Makasuhan ang mga dapat makasuhan, mabigyan ng sentence ang dapat mabigyan ng sentence within reasonable time. Wala na yung mga parking fee dapat yan sa ombudsman, sa Sandigang Bayan. Pag may kaso ka, dapat tumakbo yan. Diba?
Yeah.
I mean, let's do an audit of all the corruption cases that we have in Sandigang Bayan and ombudsman. Ano dito yung mga kaso hindi tumatakbo? Bakit hindi yan tumatakbo? Diba? We all know, of course, no, ano yung mga sinasabi na ang tawag dito, meron naman may pending kaso na, oo nga, pero ba't hindi nga tumatakbo? Kasi nga may parking fee. Diba? So, I think, you know, if we're going to do this, and I am not going to poop on anyone's party, but if we're going to do this, we have to remember that if we're going to do this, we have to do this intelligently, and we have to know what we want. We have to really know what we want. Yun lang yung reminder ko dyan. Ayun, Kuya Ibi, you wanted to say something?
Yeah, well, you know, you're exactly right, no? Na kahit ilang PRRD mo ang ilagay mo dyan sa as president, if there is no profound change, no, sa collective mindset ng Pilipino at saka yung sistema ng ating gobyerno, wala ring mangyayari, no? Of course, PRRD, no, unmistakably, he did make an impact, no, and 6 years was just too short for him, no, and in fact, he realized when he was in office that he was up against his own people, he was up against the government itself that he is leading, no. So, kung example, we remove BBM in the next days or weeks, right, and install, let's just say, Sara. So what will happen next? We still have Martin as Speaker, Chisi Scudero and the same senators, the same set of congressmen, the same mayors, the same governors, the same bureaucracy, the same people in customs extorting from the smugglers, this the same corrupt policemen, the same corrupt government officials, the same syndicates, financial syndicates, no? So, talagang ako nga eh minsan, no, you know, ever since I started this blog, no. Tama ka, 'di ba Joey, sabi mo noon about the South China Sea na SAS, you know, felt resigned na about the ano dun sa mistake nila. Kasi ang hirap nga daw, talagang hindi talaga because
I think she's doing it longer than any one of us, 'di ba?
Yes. 2016, 2015 pa yan siya nag-ano. She's been doing it for 8 years. Speaking the same thing, no? Teaching the Filipinos the same thing. Di ba? So, but 8 years. 8 years hanggang ngayon, we still see yung si Tricia, di ba? Yung si Attorney Piñol. I mean, 8 years ago, Piñol was probably just a student. Si Attorney Piñol.
Yeah.
8 years ago when SAS was articulating the arguments, di ba? Yung isa, yung si Tricia, was probably in grade school when SAS was saying, writing those essays and posts. So, talagang, you know, I mean, I will welcome change because as far as I could remember, this is the worst government I can recall running this country. Far worse than senior.
Mm-hmm. Sir Ibi, looking back, no, we were also discussing this, and you mentioned that revolution, it takes a long time. Okay. So, sinabi mo yan. And yan ay napatunayan na po sa kasaysayan. But when I was also studying my international relations in yung different country forms of government, no. Siyempre kailangan namin pag-aralan paano ba nabago yung sistema ng isang gobyerno. And it's always coming out to one common thing, and that is there was a really, really traumatic change that pushed the change. And
parang kulang tayo sa trauma.
Wala. We didn't experience it, to be honest.
Not yet. But the thing there is,
because we're too young. We're a very young country. We're a very young democracy, quote unquote.
But here's the thing. If we are waiting for it to happen the natural way, which is yung na, pag-aralan mo na, meron tayong backup plan, meron na tayong ipapalit na sistema, I don't think that's gonna happen without a trauma arising. So, ang ibig sabihin niyan is kung mag-i-install na tayo ng mga backup if anything should happen to avoid the 1986 yung change, pinalitan lang na mahinang gobyerno. But again, I'd like to just remind na may nagbago naman ngayon, no? The first is we saw what a good president can do.
Yes, okay? Yes.
So that's a very big difference, and we saw what we can deserve to have. We deserve to have, and what can be done if there is political will. Meron na yun, ang laking factor na yun sa atin. Kumbaga, alam mo ba yung isang asawa na laging binubugbog lang ng asawa, and because she thought that was normal, tinanggap na niya. And then suddenly, merong nanligaw sa kanya ng isang maayos at nirespeto siya. And then she raised this, ganito pala dapat ang asawa. So this is where we are now.
You know what?
Yes. And actually, yun yung ano, perfect na analogy, Tita Itzy.
Diba, Joey, pinag-usapan na rin natin, Joey. Mm-hmm. Diba? If a traumatic experience is what we need, ako nga eh, it's very, very radical proposal. If we can force China na talagang mag-ano na dyan sa South China Sea, talagang, you know, na talagang magkaduguan na dyan, magkaputukan na dyan. I mean, to really drive home the point na we really need change, mm-hmm. I would agree. No, I'm not saying na akong pupunta doon, but talagang, kasi wala namang ibang ano eh, for us to experience a traumatic experience, mm-hmm. I do not see anything or mm-hmm. any reason na magkakaroon, except yung sagirian sa South China Sea.
I get the point of Tita Itz, no? Yung sinabi niya kasi na parang, do we really have to wait for that traumatic experience for us to learn? Apparently, history would say that for other countries to learn, they have to undergo a very, very traumatic experience, a humiliating experience, before their national consciousness can be changed. I think the national consciousness can be changed through education, as in real deal education, and through traumatic experience. The traumatic experience can force you to learn. Okay? Now, the educating yourself, you may be able to foster change, but that is very slow. Kasi, iintayin mo na makasatumalino lahat eh. Bago tayo makagawa ng desisyon as a nation, ng mga magagandang desisyon as a nation, before we can really have a collective resolve. Ang dami mong kalaban dyan because binobobo nga tayo ng mainstream media, binobobo tayo ng mga politiko. They do not really want us to gain knowledge. They do not really want us to be educated so that we can decide for ourselves for the better. That is why I think we should know our options, okay? Kaya sabi ko, let us not just look at this as a simple na, ay hindi, kailangan nating lumabas at kailangan nating itapol kung sino ang dapat itapol. This is a long fight. This is a very, very long fight. Okay, I am hoping for a miracle. Believe me, I am hoping for a miracle. The change is going to happen sooner than expected. But we also have to understand that it is better to desire a change that is truly lasting and truly meaningful. And kung sakali na magkaroon ng traumatic experience para matutunan natin yung mga bagay na yan, then that's very good. Sa totoo lang, I do not really mind. Agree ako dun kaya, no? Kumbaga yung parang yung exasperated na puso natin na parang, sige na nga, putang ina, bigyan nyo na lang isang malupit na sanction para makaranas kami ng hirap dito at nang ma-force yung education natin. Ma-force yung national consciousness na matuto. I agree with Kuyang Ibi. I do not mind that happening. Sa totoo lang, ha? Kailangan talaga natin mapalo sa puwet eh, para matuto. But if that's not gonna happen, I am willing to die trying, you know, talking about things, educating people, opening the minds of you know, even one soul of our real situation now, unfiltered situation now. Yung hindi niroromansa ng mga PhD holder na dinidilute nila kung ano talaga yung totoong ano, ganyan-ganyan. Hindi yun na, yung totoong unfiltered situation natin. You know, to educate your fellow Filipino one soul at a time until we reach that more intelligent national consciousness for us to really make better decision for our country. That is a slow path. That is a slow path. But kagaya ng sinasabi ko, it is a slow path, but I'll die trying. I'll die trying. Eh, ganun talaga eh. Ang bagal nating matuto eh. Sobrang nakakainis eh. At yung nga, parang dapat talaga napapagsalitaan talaga tayo ng hindi magaganda eh. Diba? Nakagaya niyan. Kung ganito yung gobyerno natin, deserve natin yung ganito kabobong gobyerno kasi bobo tayong lahat eh. And ayaw natin matuto eh. Diba?
Yeah, and we also need a leader. The question is Sara that leader? Is she willing to step up to the plate if and when people will move? Diba?
And I really hope, no, na parang Inday would do that. I really hope that, I hope Inday will not dilly-dally anymore, no? Na, you know, I know there are some, you know, political master move that needs to be considered. But people are suffering. At the same time, people are suffering. How much more can we take to in enduring this kind of situation? So I really hope Inday Sara is going to, you know, move forward, consolidate our voices, and yun nga yung ano eh, yun yung maganda dun sa mga DDS eh. Kasi karamihan sa mga DDS, they really aspire more than just change in power. What we want is not to go below the standard that we experienced nung Duterte time. Diba? That is why, iba yung DDS compared dun sa mga ibang mga ano eh. Iba dun sa mga Dilawan, yung mga ano. Kasi sa totoo lang, yung mga Dilawan at mga Pinoy, wala makang prinsipyo eh. Sa totoo lang ha, wala makang prinsipyo eh.
May nakausap ako kanina na British, has a PhD in strategic studies, no? He gives lectures, no? Sabi niya, he observed na, ang sabi niya is, you know what? You need to teach Sara to find that fire in the belly, to re-examine her inspiration again daw. Because as he saw it, Inday actually lacks the confidence. Yun ang sabi niya, no?
Yun yung observation nila.
Yun ang observation niya, no? As an academic, no? He was not biased on anything, no? So, ang sabi ko, and what do you think should we do to ignite Inday Sara? He said, you keep doing what you are doing. And hopefully, a lot more of you will do what you are doing. And then she will eventually realize that there are people such as you and such as you guys, yeah, that she can draw inspiration from, and then from that she should also develop a roadmap to the goal that she will establish after she finds out her inspiration again daw. So in other words, ganun din lang, parang very simple na yung presidency example tayo sa ating professional career, meron tayong goal, di ba? Hugo tayo ng inspiration and then make a roadmap. And precisely nga, di ba, sinabi ko na rin sa iyo yung Joey, Inday Sara is actually underestimating the 32 million who voted for her. That's the real power, to be honest. That's the real power.
Sabi ni Witwit, I don't think bobo ang mga Pilipino. It's just that not everybody has the luxury to think about political situation of the country. The majority of us are busy providing for the family. I think yung, ano, no, yung kabobohan na nire-refer natin dito is yung national consciousness level. It cannot maintain nor retain it cannot remember the mistakes that we have committed in the past. Yun yung kabobohan na, you know, you don't really need to parang sa akin kailangan yan yung unang-una nating tanggapin. Yan yung kailangan unang-una na hindi natin natatandaan yung mga mali. So that's why we commit on doing the same mistakes again and again. Huwag na kayong masaktan dyan. Totoo yan. Totoo yan.
Yes.
Kagaya nga sabi ko eh, sa totoo lang, yung pinoproblema ni Tita, it's hindi naman na talaga mangyayari to kung matalino enough tayo na papanagutin yung mga Marcos nung pinababa natin sila.
Tama.
Did we? Hindi. Kaya nga nag-continue tong story na to eh. Kasi we weren't able to put the people the people accountable doon sa mga crimes na sinasabi natin na na-commit nila. Yun yung problem. Actually, nung election, na nagkakaroon ng debate tungkol doon sa ill-gotten wealth ng mga Marcoses, ganyan-ganyan. My position has always been, ito kasi yung naging problema natin dyan. Hindi natin ginalingan noon. If they really, sabi ko nga noon, hindi ko ilalagay yung leeg ko para sabihin na wala silang kasalanan. Ang problema dito is, meron silang kasalanan, pero hindi kasi natin sila nailagay sa tamang lalagyan. That is our biggest mistake. Bakit hindi natin ginalingan? Kaya sa totoo lang noon, naaasar ako dun sa mga parang laging preach ng preach, magnanako. Ang problem kasi hindi natin ginalingan noon eh. Ba? Diba? And, you know,
Joey,
hindi natin accountability dun sa mga bagay na hindi natin nagawa. That's the hard thing, no? Masakit tanggapin, pero totoo eh, kailangan talaga nating ma-realize yung mga bagay na dapat natin gawa na hindi natin nagawa.
So, inconsistent naman tayo. We have many, many politicians who were convicted felons before and they're still in office. What are we... Ano pa ba kailangan nating maintindihan na ito ay ingrained na sa ating DNA? Uulit-ulitin natin to. And the sad fact is, scholars even say, true, revolution, ang totoong revolution daw, at gusto mo ma-wipe out lahat ng mali sa isang kultura, you have to kill every single person and start all over again. And so, yung slow but sure na yan, I'm not sure if we're gonna get there. I'm not sure. And if this is what it is, then we accept the fact that we will never be able to go to that point in time that we will be holding people accountable. It is the good and bad in the Filipino, no? It is good that we forgive. We are very, very faithful and hopeful na may magbabago ang tao and that every person is, naturally a good person. There's always good left in the person. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Right? Yun yung good natin, and it's also the bad thing about us. And this is why we still have the Estradas in the office. And I'm sure this person who is in Congress right now, who was just recently, will be able to go back in office. It's not that we easily forget. We think that we can change them.
I think I would say na baka hindi nga tayo makarating dyan. Yung slow and steady na approach, maaaring hindi nga tayo makarating dyan. At maaaring maraming setback and ano. But you know what gave me hope, Tita Eats? Yung PRRD presidency, the public discourse was at its height noong panahon ni Pinoy. Because we talk about yung mga buwisit sa bansa natin during that time, yung SAF 44. May nangyari nga dito, nakalimutan na yung SAF 44, ganyan-ganyan. Actually, I think SAF 44 serve its purpose. And it should not be forgotten, no? Kaya nga, dapat binabanggit natin yan lagi parate, yung kabayanihan nila. Because I think the heroism of SAF 44 is the fact that nabuksan niya yung isipan ng maraming Pilipino na kapag nag-elect ka pala at pumili ka pala ng tamang tao para sa trabahong ito, things will change. And so, at that point, because of the public discourse that was so intense nung panahon, especially in the latter year ni Pinoy, you know, we were talking about Yolanda, we were talking about SAF 44, and other incompetencies of the president. And it resulted to changing the preference of the people. And we elected a Duterte. So, kaya ako hindi ko ina-underestimate yung educating the public. It may be slow, but it can bear fruits. But I also don't mind that we also look at other option. Posible rin yun. Wala rin problema sa akin yun. Sa akin nga, basta kahit anong change, as low, ang condition ko lang is that it has to be meaningful. It has to be meaningful. It has to be profound and meaningful. Then let's do it. It's just that, at this point, this is what I can do and this is what I can offer. But imagine if we're going to take the same mindset. All of us here, 1,179 here, is going to take the same mindset. That you are going to touch another person, your family member, your friends, your coworker, and you imbibe with them kung ano ba dapat yung national psyche na meron ang Pilipinas. because you know it may save us and it may save us and it may happen for another. It may take time to save us, but Duterte happened kasi Duterte happened eh. Because of the intense public discourse that happened, you know, ako nakikipagbardagulan talaga ako ng wagas noon. Noong mga panahon na yun, I remember. Namememohan pa ako noon.
I don't know if you can, you agree with, I'm sorry, yeah. Go ahead, Joey.
It can happen. It is slow, it may take time, but it can happen. But I am not, sabi ko nga, I am very willing to also explore yung sinasabi ni Tita Eats. Kasi, you know, sa isang banda, naaawa rin ako dun sa mga mas matatanda sa atin eh. Mm. And I think they are the ones who are getting really, really impatient.
Yes.
And I really feel the desperation in their hearts, the desperation for change, because nobody is listening. So this is my best way to really help them out. And this is also my way of expressing that I am one with you. Ganon. Mm. But let us explore our option and let us do what we can. And I think what we can right now, yung something that doesn't require capital, something that doesn't require money, something that you can do today, di ba? Something that you can do today. We are 1,170 here. Why don't we take the same mindset and perpetuate this idea? Di ba? And then probably, you know, this seed that we are going to plant now, magbubunga yan. Probably we can elect another Duterte in the next or install another Duterte, method may that be.
No comment, no comment.
Connect, diba?
No comment. But as I see it kasi, Joey, I'm 53 years old, I've seen quite a lot of things politically that happened. As I see it kasi, marami talaga sa mga Pilipino, yung bang mahiling talaga to go with the crowd, na example yung EDSA, yung 86 EDSA, it was probably less than 700,000 lang, di ba, or less than a million bata yun yung lumabas. Mm-hmm. At that time siguro nasa 60 million lang yung mga Pilipino doon, or 50 million, let's just say. So at 1 million, lagay na natin na 1 million yung lumabas doon sa EDSA nga, at 50 million yun, that's just about 20% of the population, di ba? And that was enough to topple a government. Mm-hmm. Right. Assuming we are now 115 million at 20%, so that's roughly, what, around 3 million or 3.5 million, no? Either you go out to the streets, because now the new arena of peaceful revolution, it is no longer the street. It's in social media now. This is the catalyst now, right? Mm. So that people will go out on the streets. Now, I would imagine if something like that would happen, not really far off, because yun na nga, yung Pilipino nga, mahilig sa going with the crowd, no? Because I have to tell you this honestly, no? Nung nangyari yun kasi, I was still in class, I was in high school, yung nangyari nung 86, no? Halos naglundagan lahat, no? Ng mga kaklase ko doon, no? And in fact, yung mga naglundagan doon were actually beneficiaries of the old Marcos regime, no? Mga mayayaman na may mga negosyo, may mga politiko. Mm-hmm. They were benefiting, no? But they were still naglundagan pa rin, no? And now, when Marcos Jr. came back to power, they were still the same beneficiaries of because they kept the connection, eh. Tama si Itz, eh. The connection was still there. So when Marcos Jr.
Na-reactivate lang, ano? It was a quick reactivation of the old
Marcos. Yes. And then they are now twice as many or three times as many kasi nga nanganganak na, nagkaapo na, na. So yung network nila became really wide, and then the connection was established, so talagang nagmultiply yung influence nila. So kaya I don't know if something similar to EDSA would happen, I would be happy. No, if that would happen, or something more profound and more traumatic would happen, I don't know. But yes, no. And I'll go back to yun ang sabi ni Itz kanina na kasi nga Filipinos are so forgiving for people na nasa higher class, higher status of society. hindi forgiving sa mga ordinaryo, pero when it comes to mga influential people, very forgiving tayo. Forgiving tayo sa mga pare.
Mm-hmm.
Forgiving tayo sa mga, I mean, presidente, you know, you have all those yung mga babaerong mga politiko na, you know. So pero pag ordinaryong tao, di ba? Talagang binoboldjak. Pero pagka influential na pamilya,
oo. Sabi ni Tom, nung first time na naging mayor si Sara at a very young age, maraming naging skeptical sa kanya na maging mayor. On her first day, pinakita agad niya ang kanyang kind of leadership. Lahat ng mga late at absent sa work, binigyan niya ng ultimatum. Agad niyang sinita kung bakit mahaba ang mga pila sa mga offices. Kinalampag niya ang buong city government. Kaya on the next day, hayun, biglang nagdisiplina agad ang mga empleyado sa city government. She might look lame, but she has immense power. Power siguro yan. Ayan.
Well, she doesn't look lame for me, no?
Definitely not.
Not lame. She's just confused right now, I think.
Yeah. I think yung sinabi mo kanina, kuyang, na observation na she lacks confidence. Hmm. I think it's because Inday Sara now is calculating it. Kasi yes. She is calculating. Kasi alam mo, merong ano yan eh. Tingin ko meron niyang guilt.
Trust issue. Tapos trust issues.
Oo, at saka yung guilt factor, kasi syempre, di ba, parang tayo namang karamihan sa atin, bumoto naman talaga dahil Inday was there.
Tapos she doesn't know anyone that she can trust because all of the people that she trusted before betrayed her.
Mm-hmm.
So kaya nga siya confused and hesitant ngayon. Yan ang basa ko. Kasi she can no longer sure sinong itrust niya, sinong pagkakatiwalaan niya, di ba?
I
don't want to be in thy shoes this time, to be honest.
True.
I don't want to be in thy Sara at this point of her career or of her in her life. I don't want to have anything to do with that, to be honest.
Ayun.
Actually, if she is the person we believe she is, medyo mabigat sa konsensya niya ngayon ang nangyayari. And nakikita mo yan, nababasa mo, na even when she was still the secretary and very well within yung the atmosphere ng BBM around, maingat siya, pero alam mo yung she's only trying to play her role. Yung bangkay na inaasahan sa kanya na maging cooperative and also show to the people that she can be a team player. She was doing that. Pero ramdam mo na this is not what I signed up for. Parang ganun. Kaya ngayon, konti-konti kumakawala siya. Konti-konti. Uh-huh. Pero ano rin siya eh. Alam mo, ang ganda niyang tignan. Kasi bawat pilantik ng bibig niya. Parang ano rin, isang buka lang ng bibig niya na nararatel. Right. Kasi may laman.
Pero talaga ma-prove na talagang she's carrying a really large burden.
Because
you can only throw all those one-liners pag may hugot ka. You cannot do that pag walang hugot.
Pag walang hugot eh.
You're so artificial. Look at bibig. Pero pag may hugot ka, you're carrying this really, really huge burden on your shoulder.
Uh-huh.
Talagang it's just, you know, parang ganyan lang eh. Di ba? Kasi nandyan niya lahat eh.
Mm-hmm. Ako tingin ko, no, si Inday, nandun siya sa process ng really as, really ano, no, parang, I think she knows what she's doing. Tingin ko alam rin ni Inday yung baraha niya, alam niya yung gagawin niya. But I also think that she is carrying a huge burden. Yung, alam mo yun, tingin ko kahit paano may guilt talaga yan eh, may guilt.
Meron.
Kaya ano eh, kaya hindi rin siya makabanat ng agad-agad. Kaya hindi rin siya makabanat ng agad-agad. So, maybe she is in the process of consolidating everything. And I'm really waiting for her to come back. And I hope it's not gonna take her too long.
Right.
Yun lang. Yun lang.
The country cannot wait.
Oo.
Sabi ko nga kanina, dun sa PhD, sabi niya, what do you think will happen in 2028? There will be no more Philippines if we wait for 2028.
Kasi yung sa totoo lang yung putting oligarchs in their proper places. I think only Duterte can do that. Eh. Only a Duterte can do that. So ayun, ako bibigay ko kay yung panahon kay Inday. But I hope that it's not gonna take too long.
Ay, Joey. Eh, before I forget, naalala ko yung sinabi mo na talagang biniblame, binuboldyak si Inday, na kasalanan mo to, Inday, blah, blah, blah.
Oo, di ba? Yung Inday, si Oshat yun eh, sabi ng gano'n. Bad trip siya kay Inday, sabi ng gano'n. Ay, Inday, galing na. Pagkatapos yung last statement niya, kaya pag ikaw, yun na yung naging presidente, dapat hindi ka na pwedeng umarte.
So, Joey, alam mo ha, talagang, you know, very, very inner circle, talagang ginaganyan pala talaga si Inday. Nung yung mga binujok siya ng mga close talaga niya, sasalanan mo talaga sa ito talaga. Tapos pag inimbita daw, Inday, yung ano, magdina na, bakit? Ibiblame niyo naman ako. So, sabi ko sa sarili ko, putang ina, nakakaawa naman talaga yung binujok.
True. It sucks to be Inday right now. It sucks to be Inday right now.
Yes, it really sucks to be Inday. Honestly. I don't wish to be in her shoes. Sabi ko na nga.
Ayun. Well, anyway. Ayan, Tito Itz, meron ko pang ano, last word para punta na tayo dito sa Salamat DBM.
Hindi, yun na yun po. Salamat na rin. event ko na yun lang. Speaking for those who are outside of the Philippines and yes, hoping to be able to retire home. Masakit kaya napatigil na naman ako kanina. Binigyan mo na naman ako ng malungkot na pag-iisipan, Joey, that the prognosis na makauwi para mag-retire is very dim for us who are outside. Hindi pa siguro ngayon ng panahon. Baka hindi sa lifetime namin. So, sana kayo pa yung mga, ayan, masakit yun.
Hey, wag naman, it's the, come on, be optimistic.
Yung puso ko, Tita, it's talaga, ano.
Come on. You're still young. You're still young. It's gonna happen in your lifetime.
But I do not want to have to go back to the Philippines when I can no longer walk properly at seeing yung ating PWD na walkway sa para sa mga wheelchair. Diyos ko, mamamatay ako doon.
Grabe, no? Ano? Just me?
Just on the lighter
side. I'm very glad na binungay ni KLC ang issue na yan.
You know, ang slide.
Matagal ng issue yan eh. Yung gumagawa sila ng mga PWD facility Raps for compliance purposes. But yes, you cannot really use it.
Yes.
Natawa talaga ako doon. Ano ba to? Sabi ko, multi-purpose na recreational facilities. Yes. Pwedeng slide. Pwede, pwede siyang skateboard ramp. It just goes to show that wala talaga silang empathy. They will never, wala, hindi nila ipuput. Why didn't you even try it first? It's just common sense. But again, this government is not acting with common sense right now. And yun nga. Kaya medyo malungkot, Joey, that there is a big chance that not in our lifetime we will get the government that we deserve. Yun lang.
Ay, teka, may si Raquel Tan, meron siyang marites. So sabi niya, sumabog daw yung Brahmos missile na tinetest at 7 sundalo na matay. OMG.
Well, actually somebody sent it to me, no? Yung post, no. So I researched, no, Raquel Tan. I don't know where you got the source, no. Uh-huh. But when I checked it kanina, apparently it was debunked, no. It was a fake news. It was actually a propaganda by the Pakistanis. Kasi yung Pakistani at India, rival talaga yung Pakistan at saka India, no. So it was debunked by an Indian parang official ano ng India parang military something ng India. It was debunked, no? Kasi I don't think na pag sumabog yung Brahmos missiles tapos 7 yung sundalong namatay, I don't think it will escape netizens. Yung basihan kasi ng report na yan, Joey and Raquel, is isang post ng isang Pakistani na anonymous page blog
and tweet,
no. Oh. Hindi yan galing sa Pilipinas. No?
Okay.
Eh sa sobra ba namang marites ng mga Pilipino, sumabog yung 7 na Brahmos tapos wala man lang photograph or video. Ewan ko, no. So I believe
think they got it from ano. Ito ba yung tinutukoy nyo? Ito may post si ano eh, si Maricar Serrano. Ito yung nag-tweet Intel Consortium.
Oh, yeah, parang yeah.
Explosion of Indian Brahmos missile in the Philippines, July 2.
Yes.
Exploded at launch site in the Philippines resulting in the deaths of 7 Philippine Navy troops. Bakit Navy yung ano?
Mm.
Oh, anyway, recently the Philippines had purchased 3 Brahmos missile batteries from India at cost of $375.
Mm.
Ayun.
Parang yun ata.
Mm. Okay. Okay. So anyway, well, ano, no? Kung dito sa Pilipinas yun, I'm pretty sure. Kung dito sa Pilipinas yun, I'm pretty sure maririnig yung pagsabog, di ba?
Exactly.
It cannot be, ano, it cannot be parang...
Those are Brahmos missiles, come on.
Ayun.